Well, on Hatteberg's People, if you just live life, well, that can get a little boring. But if you really live life, like Dean Holbert of rural Concordia, Kansas, then everything around you holds a story and a tale. Dean Holbert holds on to things past.
People are interested, so if they're interested, well, that's the main thing.
Now, that's Dean Holbert. He's headed to this little building that he built on his farm near Concordia. He built it because he collects stuff.
Just never throw anything away, and our folks didn't, grandparents didn't, my wife's folks didn't, so we've just got a collection of everything that we've had, just nobody gets rid of anything.
Dean loves cars, and one of his favorite things he's collected is this 1931 Ford mail truck.
We found 18 of them in the United States. The Smithsonian has one in their collection of post office stuff. Then people bring us stuff when they see something. We got something you don't have. Would you like to have that? Oh, yeah, we'll take anything. My wife kind of scowls.
Well, apparently those scowls continue because everywhere you look, Dean has created this little private museum well known in the Concordia area.
This thing is to sharpen a sickle.
And over there is this gas-powered saw.
Instead of having an electric motor on it and a power cord, it's got a little gas engine on it. This is a pan I was born in. It's a birthing pan.
And in a little room that looks like a kitchen, more history.
Yeah, that was my wife's first bought and dress in 49. See, the other side of the family kept stuff too.
He insists that most things we use today were invented years ago. Some are even more convenient in the old days than what we have today.
When your hands are full and you come to your refrigerator, well, you just reach into that little lever and
open the door. Pretty darn convenient.
My wife says I'm strange. I don't know.
In the front of the building that looks like an old gas station, he's got all kinds of things like this very clever cigarette holder. And, of course, medicines that were purchased for their alcohol content.
But there's testimonials about what it's done for you, but 14% alcohol. And the government or somebody wasn't smart enough to catch the people selling that, but the guy sold a lot of it.
Outside, the old dog waits patiently for Dean, who is not only a collector of history, but a teacher as well.
I just like old stuff. Something different.